on. Hey, resurrection people, it's Pastor Jedediah. Hey, I've been working on filling this thing up for a little while now, and it just keeps leaking out all over. Can you see that running out? I don't know if you've ever tried to fill up a basket that has everything just broken. It just doesn't hold water. This one, on the other hand, I can fill this one up. Fills up to the top, no problem. Real easy, holds water right to the top. That'll be just fine. I can get a drink out of that thing anytime I want. This guy, it's already empty again. And I gotta fill it up, and as soon as I start filling it, god darn it, just runs out all over the place. Wonder if you've ever been trying to fill your own cisterns like that. Cistern back in the Old Testament was a pool in the ground. It was a hole that held water. And they'd carve them out of rock, or they'd make them out of kind of a cement. But in the rainy season, these big pools would fill up with water, and then they would be used throughout the season to water livestock, for people to come and get drinks at when there wasn't a spring around. But if these cisterns were broken, the water would run out all over. They were kind of worthless. They wouldn't hold anything, or the dirt from around them would seep in, and then you'd have muddy water, and it wouldn't really be worth anything. Broken cisterns were junk. There was a time in Israel's history where they were forsaking God. They were leaving God. They were turning away from God, and they were following idols. They were chasing after things that were not fulfilling them. And the prophet Jeremiah came to them in right away, as he started to talk to the people in Jerusalem. In Jeremiah 2, he says, he is speaking for God. And God says, my people have committed two sins. They've forsaken me, the spring of living water, and have dug their own cisterns. Broken cisterns that cannot hold water. And as I think about today and being in this COVID-19 season, I wonder if some of your cisterns aren't holding water anymore. I wonder if you're filling cisterns that have always held water, are always easy to drink out of any time. Or if you're finding out that your cistern is empty. A lot of the times we dig our own cisterns, broken and worthless. We put our expectations into the economy. And as long as that thing's filling, we're feeling like we're doing okay. Or our financial status. Like that's going to give us life, and we're going to drink from that. And at least if our money is in good check, we're okay. Or our position, our employment, as long as we're in that corner office, as long as we're moving up the chain, as long as we're in a supervisory role or moving towards management or an owner of the company, then we're okay. Some of us put all of our worth into politics, into that cistern, into our national politics, into our state politics. Some of us put it into the relationships that we have, our marriage status. And when those things break, we know that they don't hold water. Thinking about COVID-19, many of us have dug our own cisterns called health. And we thought those would carry us through. I tell you what, a lot of us have broken cisterns. Cisterns that don't hold water anymore. Cisterns that just empty out as soon as you stop pouring into them. Or in this time, you know, we've gone back to broken cisterns. We've gone back to cisterns that never held water in the first place. And we go and see if we can drink out of them. And they're things like drugs. Those don't have life in them. Alcohol, when we use those to medicate, those don't give life. Pornography, to make you feel better or whatever that does, that doesn't hold life. I mean, even our sports, we love sports. And when they're taken away, all of a sudden we're losing ourselves. Those are cisterns that never held water in the first place. Those are cisterns we've dug ourselves. And they don't have the ability to hold water. And so I want you to think about what are the cisterns you've dug? What are your own man-made cisterns? What are the cisterns that aren't holding life during this COVID-19 season? Because they were never meant to hold life. They were never meant to be filled up and to stay full and to overflow onto others when God pours out more. There's this place in the Gospel of John where Jesus gets up and he says to everyone, he says, if anyone is thirsty, let him come to me and drink. Whoever believes in me, as the scriptures have said, streams of living water will flow from within him. God's made you into a cistern, and he's looking to fill you up. If we have created cisterns in our life that are broken, that are worthless, that don't hold water, it's probably time to start going back to the cistern that does and letting those springs of living water fill you up so that when you come to them and drink of them, they'll always be enough. You can even share with others. This stuff, it's never held water in the first place. What are your cisterns? The ones that don't hold, that were worthless, that you dug yourself because you thought maybe that would hold water. Maybe that would hold life. Maybe that would be enough. And you're finding out in this COVID-19 season that it just doesn't hold the water you thought. I think we go back to the one who says, anyone who's thirsty, come to me and I'll give you something to drink. He's the one that can fill you up and take those broken cisterns and throw them away because they've never worked in the first place. Let's pray. Lord, we give you thanks that you have streams of living water coming from you. God, I pray that you would take our broken cisterns and crush them. I pray that you would never let us go back to them. I pray that you would throw them out so that we'd never try to refill them because they were never meant to hold life anyway. God, fill us up as your cisterns that we might know a water that we will never thirst from again. Pour yourself into us that we might overflow on others. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, thanks for being with me tonight. Good to have you. If this is helpful to you, kick it around the internet, however you do that. But God bless you. Till I see you again, we'll be here tomorrow night, 6:30. God be with you.